Welcome students. This is second video session of class 8. So we are continuing with chapter 4, energy. In the last video session we have already done what is energy, what is transformation of energy, what is the law of conservation of energy, what is work done and the different criteria to be work done, situations of no work done, etc. Power also we have done. Let's start with the different forms of mechanical energy. First of all, what is mechanical energy? You have read this in class 7. What is mechanical energy? Suppose if I lift a stone above the ground, I am doing some work again, in raising the stone against the force of gravity, because the gravity wants the stone to, it will want the stone to fall downwards, right? So we are spending some energy in raising the stone above the ground. So where does this energy go then? Some of that energy gets stored in the stone in form of mechanical energy. So basically the energy possessed due to some work done on it is known as a mechanical energy. It is of two types, potential and kinetic energy. Okay. Potential energy is that form of mechanical energy which is possessed due to the position or the configuration of a body, okay, which is again of two types, gravitational potential energy, elastic potential energy. That form of potential energy which is stored in a body due to the raised height of the body. Suppose this is a ground and this is the body, or say the marker, it's lying on the ground. Now when I'm just lifting the marker above the ground, see, it is being raised to a certain height. Due to this raised position, it acquires the form of energy known as a gravitational potential energy. Okay, why gravitational potential energy? Because we are doing some work against the force of gravity. We are spending some energy raising the stone. Okay. Now, again, another one is the elastic potential energy. What is elastic potential energy? It is that form of potential energy which is possessed by a body when it is compressed or bent. For example, a stretched, say, bow, or say a stretched catapult. When you release it, when it is stretching the catapult, what type of energy does it possess? It will possess elastic potential energy. And when you just release it, the stone in it flies off with a great speed. How come it's getting the energy from? The stone is getting the kinetic energy. What is kinetic energy? The energy possessed by a body due to motion. Any body which is in motion will possess kinetic energy. Okay? So, the stone is getting the kinetic energy from the elastic potential energy. See, this is also another example of the transformation of energy. Elastic potential energy to the kinetic energy. So, we can measure this gravitational potential energy and kinetic energy. In this chapter, you will learn that. First of all, how can we measure kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is written as mathematically half into mass into velocity square. That is half mv square. Half into mass into velocity square. That means if more is the mass, suppose two bodies are moving in same speed. Okay. One is a heavier body, another one is a lighter body. That means the heavier body, which will have more mass, will possess more kinetic energy. Again, if two bodies, say, having the same mass but are moving with different speed, which one will have more kinetic energy? The body having more velocity. Direct relation. That is why. You will get numericals from this part. Now let's come to the gravitational potential energy. This is measured as, or you can simply write PE, mg mgh, mass into acceleration due to gravity. Which is taken as 9.8 meter per second square, constant on Earth's surface. And what is this h? Can you just imagine why are we using this term mgh? Mg is the force, that means the weight of the body which is acting downwards, under which it will fall down. H is the height at which the body is raised above. So see, the body is displaced, that is why we can say that due to the raised height, gravitational potential energy is equal to mgh into the height. H stands for height, height above the surface above which it is raised. Okay, so basically mechanical energy is possessed by a body due to either position or configuration, which will come under potential energy, or due to motion, which will come under kinetic energy. Okay, because in both the cases, work is done. Okay, and we have done what is elastic potential energy also. So you can get different conversions of energy. For example, potential energy to kinetic energy. When water falls in a dam, from a dam, when the water is stored in a dam, what type of energy will it possess? Potential energy. In precise, gravitational potential energy, because water is stored at certain height above the ground, so it will possess gravitational potential energy. And when it falls, water is flowing, that means it is falling, it is in motion, so it will possess kinetic energy then. So potential energy to kinetic energy, and that water will rotate the blades of the turbine, and this is used in hydroelectric dams to generate electricity. That means when we use water as the source of energy to produce electricity. So just can you tell me, the flower pot placed at roof of a building, what type of energy is possessed by the flower pot? Gravitational potential energy. Why? Because it is raised at certain height. That is why. Compressed spring, it is potential energy. What kind of potential energy? Elastic potential energy. Why? Because the spring is compressed. Due to compressed, being compressed or bent, energy possessed is elastic potential energy. Stretched catapult, stretched bow, same thing. Example of elastic potential energy to kinetic energy. Just now I said, you have a stretched catapult and you have a stone attached at one end. You release the catapult, the stone will fly off. Why? Because it gets the kinetic energy. It will fly off means it will possess some kinetic energy due to motion. Due to the, that means energy, elastic potential energy stored in the stretched catapult, stretched, is elastic potential energy getting converted to kinetic energy. And we will learn different examples of potential energy to kinetic energy when we will do the few examples of conservation of energy. And I hope you remember few examples of conservations of, the transformation of energy, like electrical energy to light energy, electric bulb, electrical energy to sound energy, electric bell. Then various other examples, you have some examples in your book also, and we have done all this in the previous course. Okay, so now let's go to the different examples of the conservation of energy. See the first one, roller coaster. You have done previously also. Suppose in a roller coaster, when the car is at the topmost portion of the roller coaster, say this is the ground, then it will possess maximum potential energy. Why maximum? Because see, the height from the ground is maximum. Say if the coaster is like this from the ground, More the height, more the potential energy. M G H, obviously. More the H, more is height, more is the potential energy. So, at the maximum point, maximum potential energy. Now see, when it comes down gradually, height is decreasing. So, height is decreasing means potential energy is decreasing. But what about the decreased energy? Will it just vanish? No. Because energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. Law of conservation of energy. So, some part of the potential energy gets converted to kinetic energy with which the car is moving down in motion. As it moves down gradually, potential energy keep on decreasing, kinetic energy keep on increasing. At the bottom, maximum. Here you have maximum potential energy, no kinetic energy. As it goes down, potential energy decreases, kinetic energy increases. At the bottom, maximum kinetic energy and no potential energy. Why no potential energy? Because it is at the ground. Does it have any height above the ground? Height above the ground is zero. Again, when it goes up, same thing happens. It repeats. So, goes on and on. And this is how energy is conserved. Hydroelectric power plant. Water is stored in the dam at certain height. Water possesses potential energy because it is above a certain height from the ground. Now, when the water falls, what will happen? Potential energy will gradually go on decreasing. Kinetic energy will increase. When it reaches the bottom, full conversion to kinetic energy. Potential energy to kinetic energy. Because the water is flowing in motion. This moving water actually rotates the, suppose if this is a blade, the blades of the turbine, if the water moves, it will rotate the blades of the turbine. And this is how electricity is generated in the hydroelectric power plant. So, if you get the question, example of potential energy to kinetic energy, you can give this example or this example. Simple pendulum, what happens? What is a simple pendulum? You have a rigid string. This is a support. This is a support from which I am just attaching a, hanging a string to which is attached a metallic sphere-like structure known as the bob. Okay, this is a simple pendulum. Now, suppose this is a string and you have a bob attached. I am just pulling the bob to certain extent and then I am releasing my hand. What will you find? You will find that it will oscillate to and fro like this. It will keep on moving to and fro. So, the maximum extent to which it will move on both sides are the extreme positions. So, A and B are the extreme positions. Okay? And this is the mean position. Now what will happen? That means it will go to certain extent, after that it will automatically want to come back to its own position. Again like this, again like this. So, just see, if this is the reference level, when the bob moves to the maximum position on both the sides, can you see, it is being raised to the maximum height. That means, at A and B, in this case also, see, this is the height from the surface, the reference level in this case also. So, In both the cases A and B, it will possess maximum potential energy due to the maximum height. When it will come move, that will start moving towards the mean position, what will happen? Gradually, see the height is decreasing gradually. Can you see the height? Gradually decreasing and here zero. That means maximum potential energy. When it starts moving towards C, potential energy decreases, kinetic energy increases. At C, maximum kinetic energy, potential energy zero because it is at the reference level. So if this is the pendulum, so basically when it's moving like this, potential energy maximum goes on decreasing, kinetic energy increases. Height zero above the ground, potential energy is zero, kinetic energy maximum again like this, same thing. So it keeps on changing from potential energy to kinetic energy, but always throughout the journey, the sum of potential and kinetic energy remains constant. No energy is lost or no energy is created. Okay? So the last portion, it's a very small part, that is a work energy relationship. What is that? Work done by a body is equal to the energy change in a body. Okay, just like you have learned, suppose you raise a marker above the surface to a certain height, we are doing some work and we are spending some energy, it is gained by the marker. Now that is stored in the marker in the form of gravitational potential energy. Or in other terms we can say that work done by a body will be equal to the energy change in the body. Suppose if there is a moving body, okay, initially it was at rest, now it is moving. The change in the kinetic energy will be equal to the work done by the body. If we have a body which we are displacing from a certain level to another level, change in potential energy due to the change in heights will be the work done by the body then. Okay, so basically we will use this work energy relationship when we will do the numericals. Okay, then it will be easier for you to follow. So that's all for the theory part, and in the next session we will do the numericals of this chapter.